It's not easy to slip unnoticed into the piercing world of Formula One. Especially when your product is all about delivering a kick. And your company image is the beast that wreaks havoc in China's shops. But for almost a decade and a half, Red Bull lay like sleepers in Grand Prix racing. Deep-rooted, but dormant. Powerful, but patient. There were the Sauber years, with no prizes to show. The sleepers slept. In 2004, a for sale sign went up over Jaguar Racing, and the bull stirred and pawed the ground. The network spread, not just one team now, but two. The designs were now grand. Adrian Newey took his place at the technical end, and David Coulthard sat behind the wheel. Was this the moment? Not yet. In 2008, Coulthard retired. And in 2009, the team of Sebastian Vettel and Mark Webber slid into the RB5. And the beast lowered its head and locked its horns.
It's Red Bull on a charge!
Beef against brawl.
Jenson Button's run is over!
Second place in the Drivers' Championship. Second in the Constructors. And now in 2010, six pole positions in six Grand Prix. Vettel and Webber, 2-1-2s in the last four races, a first and third in Spain. Webber, the winner of the last two races, two Red Bull drivers on equal points at the top of the Drivers' Championship. Red Bull, the leading constructors. The sleepers sleep no more. The bull is on the charge as the storm heads for the Turkish Grand Prix. Red Bull in Istanbul. None shall sleep here.